Hello students, welcome to RH Chemistry. Today I am going to discuss in chemistry the final punch KCET previous year questions from 2014 to 2018 P block elements group 15 to group 18, that is in the second PUC, we know that. And 2019 paper already I have solved and the link is given in the description box, so you can refer. So before going to start with P block element, let us first discuss about this synopsis part. This is synopsis we will discuss. First we will say group 15. So in case of the group 15, we know that general configuration is NS2NP3 and the oxidation state, if you consider, so oxidation state of this is, remember, so plus 3, plus 5 and minus 3, right? So except bismuth, all shows allotropy, remember that point. Except bismuth, all elements shows allotropy in this particular case. And if you consider the oxidation state, so plus 3 plus 5 and minus 3 is common, plus 3 plus 5 and minus 3 is common, and plus 5 oxidation state decreases, plus 3 and minus 3 increases down the group. That is due to, remember, inert pair effect. That is due to inert pair effect. Remember that point. Then we will see the part hydrides in this particular case. So hydrides, you can see. Then we will see the oxides. In case of the hydrides, remember, NS3, PS3, ASS3, SBS3 and BIS3 is possible. So first one, bond dissociation energy. As we know, down the group, I am written here, down the group size increases. Hence, remember, bond dissociation energy decreases. Bond dissociation energy decreases, basic nature decreases. Basic nature, here we are talking about Lewis basic nature, remember, Lewis basic nature. So it decreases because NS3 is also having one lone pair, BIS3 is also having one lone pair, but down the group size increases. As the size increases, the pair of electron distributed over the large volume, because of that reason, remember, you are going to see basic nature decreases, NS3 is the strongest Lewis base. Bond angle decreases. Remember, bond angle of NS3 is more than BIS3. Bond angle decreases because electronegativity decreases. So bond angle decreases, the reason is electronegativity decreases. Stability is also decreases, the reason is bond dissociation energy decreases. Stability decreases, bond dissociation energy decreases. Reducing nature increases because bond dissociation energy decreases once again. Because reducing nature is nothing but ability to give hydrogen, that will increase us when bond strength is less. Hence, reducing nature increases. But boiling point, very important, remember, boiling point, so it is not the common order. So BIS3 is more due to molecular mass. Molecular mass is more, hence BIS3 is more than SBS3. This is also molecular mass. But then ASS3 we can expect, but NS3 is more because NS3 is having, remember, hydrogen bonding. Because of the hydrogen bonding in this particular case, the NS3 is having more boiling point than ASS3 than PH3. Remember this order, very important. Then we'll move to oxides. E2O3, E2O5, two oxides are possible. Oxidation state of E2O3 is plus 3 and here element is plus 5. So one thing you remember, as oxidation state increases, acidic strength increases. This is the universal statement, very, very important for any of the oxides. As down the group, remember, acidic nature decreases. Oxidation state increases, acidic strength increases. But down the group, if you consider, acidic nature decreases because basic nature increases, because metallic nature increases. If bismuth, if you consider, bismuth is a metal. Metal oxide is always basic in nature. Hence, remember, basic nature decreases. Then if I consider nitrogen oxides, so these are the six oxides possible: N2O, NO, N2O3, NO2, N2O4, N2O5, and oxidation state also I have written. So important point about these oxides you have to remember. First one, N2O is colorless. Remember, neutral. Very important, N2 is neutral, N2, NO is neutral. These are the two neutral oxides of nitrogen. Very, very important. Make sure this point should be remembered. So, neutral, colorless, and the resonating structure is written like this. N, triple bond, N, single bond, O. In on the resonating structure, brother, N, double bond, N, double bond, O, it becomes. Once it was asked in CET, remember. Then NO. NO is, remember, paramagnetic in nature. So, wherever magnetic nature is not written, the meaning is diamagnetic. But paramagnetic I have shown separately. So NO is paramagnetic, odd electron molecule. Calculate the number of electron. It is odd electron molecule. And neutral, remember, very, very important. Neutral, N double bond. N2O3 is blue. Remember this point. This is a hint. blue color, N2O3. This is the only blue color, N2O3, and the structure is like this. N2O4 is a dimer of NO, because dimerization is possible only when, remember, the oxide is odd electron. See, NO is also odd electron. NO can undergo dimerization. NO is also here, NO2 it is, sorry. NO2 also odd electron. NO2 also can undergo dimerization. NO also can undergo dimerization. It is a dimer of NO2. NO2. Remember that. So N2O5 is anhydrous of HNO3. How it is? See, HNO3 if I consider, HNO3, two molecule you have to take. When you heat, minus water molecule. Water molecule if you remove, remaining is H2 is removed, one oxygen is removed, remaining is N2O5. So it is anhydrous of HNO3. Remember that point. So this is about oxides of nitrogen. Then we'll move to halides. Very important. Halides once again. Halides, you can see stability of the halides. NF3 more stable than NCl3, NBr3. NCl3 is explosive in nature. Remember that. Explosive in nature. NCl3. That is NCl3. Lewis basic strength if I consider. Lewis basic strength. Ni3 is more than NBr3, more than NCl3, more than NF3. In case of NF3, why this basic strength is less is because, remember, fluorine and nitrogen can form back bonding. Because of the smaller size of the fluorine and bond length is less, hence N and F can form black bonding. So nitrogen electron is not available for the Lewis base donation of electron. Hence Ni3 is more. Then bond angle if you consider, bond angle, center element is the same. Now here you can see the bond angle. So center element is different. I told electronegativity decreases. So bond angle decreases. So here also will follow the same. So when electronegativity is more, see, bond angle is less. So which one is surrounded? It is center, same. Surrounded electronegativity decreases, bond angle increases. Center electronegativity decreases, bond angle decreases. Remember, surrounding electronegativity decreases down the group, decreases fluorine to iodine, the bond angle is increasing. Nitrogen cannot form pentahalide. So many times it was asked. Nitrogen cannot form pentahalide. The reason for that is absence of d orbital. Absence of d orbital. One thing you remember, among all these elements, nitrogen is absence of d orbital. Because of that reason, it can form only p pi multiple bond. But this oxygen can form, phosphorus can form d pi also. But nitrogen can form only p pi multiple bonds. Remember that point. So this is about the nitrogen. The halides, halides, oxides, hydrides, and this oxides of nitrogen. Then we'll move to nitrogen we'll see, right? So nitrogen, first we'll see the preparation. So in case of the preparation, you can see, so here I will show you like this. So these are the preparation of nitrogen. Then we'll see the properties. See, first preparation is that NH4NO2 give rise to N2. NH4NO2 on heating give rise to N2. Very, very important in this particular case. Remember that. So NH4Cl plus NaNO2 on heating is also give rise to N2. Ammonium dichromate on heating give rise to N2. NS3CuO give rise to N2. Very, very important is this one. Very, very important. BaN3 twice or NaN3. Barium azide or sodium azide. Remember, barium azide or sodium azide. Very, very important. So when it is heated, thermal decomposition give rise to, remember, nitrogen gas. These are the preparation of nitrogen gas. Then properties. So properties, one after the other, you can see. So metals to form nitrites. Nitrogen react with metals to form nitrites. Remember, nitrites. So calcium carbide, when the nitrogen react with calcium carbide, so it is going to give rise to calcium cyanamide, we call it as CaCN twice. Calcium cyanamide plus carbon. So this mixture is called as nitrolim, which is used as a fertilizer. Nitrolim, which is used as a fertilizer, remember that. Then Haber's process, we know that very important process. Haber's process, hydrogen, nitrogen react with each other to form NS3 in the presence of iron as a catalyst. Ammonia is formed. This ammonia, remember, nitrogen is sp3 hybridized and pyramidal structure. Very famous one that we know. And in laboratory also we have seen Nestler's reagent, when it reacts with ammonium radical, it is going to give rise to brown precipitate. So very important, but very important, very very important is NH3 when it oxidized in presence of oxygen to form NO, NO react with oxygen to form NO2, NO2 on dissolving in water to form HNO3. The process is called as what? Ostwald process. Remember, Ostwald's process. So this Ostwald process so give rise to ammonia. This HNO3 oxidizing the very good acid HNO3. So nitric acid. Now this nitric acid oxidizing nature, you have to remember oxidizing nature, very important. Nitric acid when it reacts with non-metals, I consider non-metal, carbon give rise to H2CO3, sulfur give rise to H2SO4, I2 give rise to HIO3, boron give rise to H3BO3 and phosphorus give rise to H3PO4. Remember, phosphorus give rise to H3PO4. These are the non-metal product formed when HNO3 react. For all these, remember, byproduct is NO2 plus H2O. Remember, NO2 plus H2O is the byproduct in all these cases. So I have not written that. But remember that carbon give rise to H2CO3, sulfur H2SO4, iodine HIO3, boron H3BO3, phosphorus H3PO4. So then in this particular case, remember, so HNO3 oxidizing nature with metals, See, HNO3 oxidizing nature with metals, I have considered it in two part. One is more electropositive. Another one is less electropositive than hydrogen. More electropositive than hydrogen, less electropositive than hydrogen. Right. So more electropositive than hydrogen. I have explained in the last video, electrochemical series. Correct. So in electrochemical series, which are having the positive reduction potential value. Remember, magnesium, manganese, zinc, tin, iron, magnesium, all this. Very dilute HNO3. So here four types, very dilute HNO3, magnesium manganese gives H2 gas. Remember that. Cold dilute HNO3, zinc, tin, iron, magnesium gives NH4NO3. One thing you have to remember, NH4NO3, when it is heated, you will get N2O gas. But see, NH4NO2 when it is heated, you will get N2 gas. Very important difference, gottirli. NH4NO2, one oxygen less, N2. One oxygen is more, N2O. Remember that. Then more electropositive than hydrogen, right? So cold dilute HNO3 give rise to NH4NO3. So hot dilute HNO3, definitely it will form. Then because of this heat, hot, N2O is going to form. Concentrated HNO3 are going to get NO2, nitrogen dioxide. Remember that, concentrated HNO3, NO2, except tin. Tin gives, remember, H2SNO3 and NO2. H2SNO3 and NO2, remember that. So then a less electropositive than hydrogen, chap metals. Chap metals means, here C means copper, H means mercury, A means Ag, not Au, Ag, P means platinum. So actually this platinum also not possible, so platinum will remove that. Cha metals, astronomical petroleum. So then H2 gas is not released. Very important, in the last class also I told. So H2 gas is not released. Remember, very two is simple. With concentrated HNO3 give rise to NO2. With dilute HNO3 give rise to NO. But the difference is, remember, with dilute HNO3 N2O gas, with dilute HNO3 NO gas. So copper, mercury, silver, all these things, with dilute HNO3 NO gas, with dilute HNO3 all these metals electropositive, N2O gas. This difference you have to remember, very very important. So this is about nitrogen. Yes, now you open your eyes. So phosphorus, we will see phosphorus. See, phosphorus in this particular case, three allotropic forms. One is white phosphorus, black phosphorus, red phosphorus. Now first we will see black phosphorus. Black phosphorus, in which alpha and beta black phosphorus is possible, and more stable, important ones it was asked, more stable allotropic form of the phosphorus means which one? That is more stable black phosphorus. Remember that point. So then red phosphorus. Red phosphorus, less reactive, non-poisonous, does not glow in dark. Less reactive, non-poisonous, does not glow in dark, and polymeric P4 units are present. Then white phosphorus, more reactive, poisonous, glows in dark, discrete P4 unit. Is polymeric, it is discrete, single unit. More reactive, poisonous. Thus more reactive, I have shown some reactions. See. So here, first one, remember, in this particular case, so white phosphorus reacts with whom? NaOH and H2O. important. White phosphorus react with NaOH and H2O forming phosphine. Phosphine we call it as PH3. What all the nature? Poisonous nature, remember, poisonous. Pure form is non-inflammable. Important, remember, pure form is non-inflammable. So with CuSO4 forming Cu3P2, with used in Ohm's signal, with oxygen forming P2O5, remember, with oxygen forming P2O5. This is phosphine properties. Then slowly we'll move to another. White phosphorus reacts in two ways. That is Clt excess, Cl2 limited. Remember, Clt excess, PCl5, Cl2 limited, PCl3. Very simple. So white phosphorus reacts. So Clt excess, PCl5, Cl2 limited, PCl3. Then PCl5 reacts. See, PCl5 reactions, you can see. PCl5 reacts with on heating PCl3, Cl2. On heating. sp3 dehybridization for phosphorus. Here sp3 dehybridization means trigonal bipyramidal structure. One point about that structure is that axial bonds are longer than equatorial bonds. Remember that point. In solid state, ionic solid, it is called as ionic solid. Remember, ionic solid. In solid state, PCl4 plus and PCl6 minus is going to form. Hence it is conduct electricity. Very, very important point. So this point is very important. Remember, PCl5 can conduct electricity because it is presence in the form of ionic solid PCl4 plus and PCl6 minus. Then with moisture, water, POCl3 plus HCl. With moisture, POCl3 plus HCl. Then that POCl3 further reacts with H2O to form S3PO4. How to remember? Phosphorus is plus 5 oxidation state. S3PO4, in which phosphorus is plus 5 oxidation state. Remember in that way. Once the question was asked, when PCl5 was the exposed to moisture, white fumes are formed. What is the formula? White fumes are HCl. Remember that. White fumes are HCl. Then PCl3. Then if you see PCl3, PCl3 with water forming S3PO3 and HCl. One thing you remember, S3PO3 and HCl, similar to this. PCl3 plus 3 oxidation state and S3PO3 is also plus 3 oxidation state. Then sp3 hybridized and pyramidal structure. sp3 hybridized and pyramidal structure, remember that point. Then oxoacids of phosphorus, I have given directly hypophosphorus acid antandre S3PO2, orthophosphorus S3PO3, orthophosphoric S3PO4, pyrophosphorus S4P2O5, pyrophosphoric H4P2O7, hypophosphoric H4P2O6, metaphosphoric HPO3. So I want one separate class for this. I will make another small video how to draw the structures of oxoacids of phosphorus, sulfur and chlorine and its nature, basicity and its reducing nature. All those things I will explain in the another small video. Fine. Now here only you remember this much. Then one thing you remember in that S3PO3 orthophosphoric acid, S3PO3 orthophosphorus acid can undergo disproportionation. Disproportionation reaction under, you know, the one element undergo both oxidation as well as reduction. See, plus 3 oxidation state forming minus 3 and plus 1. Hence it is called as disproportionation reaction to form phosphine and S3PO4. Phosphoric acid, remember that point. This is about P4. This is about P4. So now we will see the group 17. Group 17 only I have taken very small part. It is oxoacids of sulfur. So this oxoacids of sulfur also in detail I am going to explain in the separate video. So oxoacids of sulfur, remember, these are the 5 acids: sulfurous acid, sulfuric, peroxo monosulfuric, oleum, peroxo disulfuric. Peroxo, wherever it is there, remember, peroxide linkage is present. For this also and for this also, peroxide linkage is present. Remember that oxoacids of sulfur, these are the oxidation state. So for sulfur or oxygen family, I have taken only this much. So remember, this much is important in this case. So after this, let us move to the group 17. So group 17. So group 17, very, very important part. Group 17, we will see. In case of the group 17, one by one we will see. First, remember its nature. First one, F2 is light yellow, Cl2 is greenish yellow, Br2 is reddish brown, I2 is violet, black in solid. Now, first of all, these nature, very, very important. See, electron gain enthalpy order, exceptional order, nenpittukoli. Electron gain enthalpy order, exceptional order, in which Cl more than F more than Br more than I. So F we expected here, F more than Cl, but Cl more than F due to F smaller size, remember, smaller size of F. oxidizing nature. F2 is very strong oxidizing agent. I2 is having very weak oxidizing nature, which means among the following good reducing nature anta kelidre I2. Bond dissociation energy, very very important, very very important bond dissociation energy, because exception it is. Here also I told exception. Exception means what we expect, it is not according to that. Bond and dissociation energy, you can Cl2 more than Br2 more than F2 more than I2. So Cl2, Br2, F2 and I2. Electronegativity, F more than Cl more than Br more than I, we know that F is more. But here, F we expected here. But because of the FF smaller size, remember. So because of the FF smaller size, so inter-electronic repulsion will be there. Because of inter-electronic repulsion, this F2 is having less bond dissociation energy. Then we'll move to hydrides. Hydrides, very very important this group part. Hydrides means HF, HBr, HCl, HI. These are the four. Now bond strength down the group, size increases, bond strength decreases, so bond strength decreases. Thermal stability, size increases, bond strength decreases, thermal stability also decreases. Reducing nature, ability to give hydrogen increases, increases because bond length increases, bond strength decreases. So bond strength decreases means reducing nature increases. So very very important melting and boiling point order. This order you can see, I have written, these are all decreases, increases because it is a common order. But this is important. Melting point of HI is more because of molecular mass. Then HF due to hydrogen bonding. Then boiling point of HF is more because hydrogen bonding. So always remember, for boiling point, hydrogen bonding predominates for molecular mass. Melting point, molecular mass predominates over hydrogen bonding. So melting point anta bandaga HI is more than HF because the molecular mass of HI predominates over hydrogen bonding. But HF is more than HI boiling point because HI's molecular mass is more, but hydrogen bonding predominates over HI boiling point order. Ionic nature decreases. Ionic nature decreases. Definitely electronegativity decreases. Ionic nature decreases. Acidic nature increases. Important part, which is a strong acid. HI, remember, HI is the strong acid among all these. This is about hydrides. Then we'll see interhalogen compounds. Interhalogen compounds. See that interhalogen compound I have considered XY, XY3, XY5, XY7. So in this case, X should be larger, Y should be smaller. Ishtan nenpittukolri, center should be larger, surrounding should be smaller, XY. What all the possibility? XY, see CLF, BRF, IF, BRCL, IBR, ICL. All these are possible. The structure is linear shape. XY3, what all the possible? Only 4 molecule. Remember that. Only 4 molecule. CLF3, BRF3, IF3. See, F is possible with all because it is smaller one. So stability is there. But ICL3, fourth one. T-shape molecule. XY5. CL5, BRF5, IF5. With fluorine is all is possible. Square pyramidal shape. Square pyramidal. So XY7, IF7 is the only one possible. Remember, IF7 is the only one possible. So XY7, remember, very important, IF7 is the only one possibility, pentagonal bipyramidal structure. It's a structure, pentagonal bipyramidal structure, remember that. And how to identify the hybridization and structure, I have already done one small video on that. So that the link also description I have given, so you can refer that. Now we'll go to oxo acids of halogen. See that oxo acids of halogen form 4 possible, HXO, HXO2, HXO3, HXO4. Correct? So F forms only one oxo acid. When 2018 NEET question it was asked, remember, F form only one oxo acid in which fluorine is +1. In this oxidation state of fluorine is 2, +1. This is the only molecule where fluorine is +1. Very, very, very important. Remember that. Now, acidic nature we will see. In this case, acidic nature, as oxidation state increases, acidic nature increases. Universal point, remember. As oxidation state increases, acidic nature increases. See, oxidation state of Cl is +7, +5, +6, +3, +1. Right? Here it is +1, here it is +3, here it is +5, here it is +7. So oxidation state of HClO4, more. Hence, remember, more strongest acid. First of all, remember, HClO4 is the strongest acid. Right? Oxidation state increases, acidic nature increases. Electronegativity increases, acidic nature increases. See, electronegativity increases. See, Cl2, Br2, I. Electronegativity means more, acidic nature is more, then HBrO3, then HIO3. Remember that. Thermal stability. thermal stability and this acidic nature almost the same. HClO4 more than HClO3 more than HClO2 more than HClO. But oxidizing nature is opposite to this. Oxidizing nature HClO is more than HClO2 more than HClO3 more than HClO4. Remember this point important. Oxoacids of halogen. Let us move to last part in this case. Aquaregia. Aquaregia means what? 1:3 mixture of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated HCl. So last year JE exam it was asked. When concentrated HNO3 reacts, what is oxidation state, remember, of nitrogen? So concentrated HNO3, concentrated HCl, 1:3 mixture aquaregia. Aquaregia will dissolve gold and platinum. Gold and platinum. What is the reaction? See, gold react with H++ NO3 minus plus HCl minus. This is come from aquaregia forming AuCl4. Remember this important. +5 oxidation state decreases to +2. +5 oxidation state decreases to +2. Then platinum also same. Platinum give rise to PtCl6 3 minus. +5 oxidation state of nitrogen decreases to +2. This is about aquaregia, which will dissolve gold and platinum very, very easily. Remember that point. So before going to start with group 18, here is a small, the Cl2 reactions, important Cl2 reaction. See, Cl2, see Cl2, MnO4 plus HCl. First of all, remember MnO2 is the black color solid, black color. MnO2 react with HCl give rise to Cl2. Then KMnO4 with HCl also give rise to Cl2, or potassium dichromate oxidizes HCl give rise to Cl2. This is decons process O2 plus 4 HCl. HCl is oxidized in presence of CuCl2 as a catalyst forming Cl2. Then its reaction. Bleaching agent in the moisture. Moisture it acts as a bleaching agent. Because in the moisture it acts as oxidizing agent. This oxidizing agent is the property behind bleaching agent. Remember. So oxidizing agent. Then important reaction. Formation of bleaching powder. Cl2 react with slaked lime, remember. So slaked lime under CaO is twice. Give rise to CaOCl twice, CaCl2S2. This mixture is called as bleaching powder. Then Cl2 react with sulfur dioxide to form SO2Cl2. Then I am going to give rise to, going to give two important reactions. Very, very important. Remember, one is excess NS react with Cl2 to form NH4ClN2. NS3 react with excess of Cl2 forming NCl3 and HCl. How to remember? Product not necessary to remember, but only thing you remember that N is excess. So the N is excess, so both containing N. Cl is excess, so both containing Cl. Is to remember, that is enough. Both containing nitrogen, N excess. Both containing Cl, Cl excess. Now, another reaction. Cl2 react with NaOH. Cl2 react with NaOH, cold and dilute, hot and concentrated. Very, very important. Cold and dilute, remember, you are going to get NaCl, NaOCl, H2O. Hot and concentrated NaCl, H2O common, but NaClO3. Remember, 0 to minus 1, plus 1. 0 to minus 1, plus 5. This is also disproportionation reaction. Because Cl0 oxidized and reduced both. But important to remember the product. NaOCl, NaClO3. Instead of this, you can give it like this also. ClO3 minus and ClO minus or OCl minus. Both are same. NaClO3 plus 5, NaOCl plus 1. Important, hot and concentrated NaClO3. Cold and dilute NaOCl. Very, very important. Remember that. Then lastly, we will go to group 18. Very important and very simple. Very simple, very important. Right? So, now, first one you will see, group 18, these are the element, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, correct? So first, these properties you remember, half of the work is done in case of group 18, very, very important. So H2 plus O2 give rise, which is used in oxygen cylinder, He it is, He, right? So remember, this is He plus O2, mixture is used in oxygen cylinder and also which is used by asthma patients, remember. Second one, once it was asked, statement type of question, these uses are very, very useful. Remember that superconducting magnets to prepare that helium is used. Inert atmosphere for welding, helium is used. Helium source is natural gas, very, very important. Remember, helium source is natural gas. Helium is the one which is having lowest boiling point among all the substance. Helium is used in filling balloons instead of hydrogen. Hydrogen is lighter, we know that. But hydrogen is highly inflammable. So remember, it is non-inflammable, hence which is used in filling balloons, and highly diffused through glass, plastic and rubber. Once it was asked in CET, remember. So this is the only noble gas which can highly diffuse through glass, plastic and rubber very easily. So this is about helium. Then neon. Fluorescent bulb will use martivi. Neon is used in fluorescent bulb and it can carry extreme high current. Because of that reason, it is used in advertising purpose bulbs also. Remember that. Then argon, to provide inert atmosphere, important inert atmosphere in welding, but important is more abundant noble gas. Which is the more abundant noble gas? Argon. Fluorescent bulb, this is also used. And these, krypton, photography it is used. Xenon, high penetrating bulbs it can be used. Xenon, high penetrating bulb which is used in the which will be there in the aeroplane aircraft ways, remember, that is in the aeroplane where it will move, where that light will be present, that is of xenon, because xenon is having high penetrating power. So then radon. Radon is obtained from radium. Remember, radium, radon is radioactive and used in cancer treatment. Very important, cancer treatment. Then first noble gas compound is which one? XCPTF6, xenon platinum hexafluoride compound. So who prepared Neil Bartlett? Who prepared Neil Bartlett? And which factor made him to prepare XCPTF6? Remember, O2 and xenon has same ionization energy. Don't forget this. Same ionization energy. O2 and xenon has same ionization energy is the one which, because of this reason, he tried to prepare the compound, and he prepared this compound, very, very important, XCPTF6. Then finally, xenon compounds. Xenon compounds, these are the compounds you have to remember. Remember, how to calculate hybridization? Once again, I have made that video, hybridization, how to identify, very important, very simple for the competitive exams. So you can refer that, the link is given in the description box. Then XCF2 give rise to, XCF2 say sp3d hybridization, 3 lone pair linear structure. XCF4 sp3d2 2 lone pair square planar. XCF6 sp3d3 1 lone pair distorted octahedral. Not necessary to remember any of this as a biotin. ಬಯಟ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನೆನ್ಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡೈಸೇಷನ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲಿ. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. XCO3 SP3 1 ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ ಸೊ ಪಿರಾಮಿಡಲ್. XCO2 F2 SP3D 1 ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ ಸೀಸಾ. XCOF4 SP3D 2 1 ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪಿರಾಮಿಡಲ್. XCOF2 SP3D 2 ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ ಸೊ ಟಿ ಶೇಪ್. ಸೊ XCO4 SP3 0 ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ ಟೆಟ್ರಾಹೆಡ್ರಲ್ ಶೇಪ್. ಸೊ but important three reactions I will tell you, note down this point. XCF6, when it undergo hydrolysis, remember, you are going to get XCOF4. XCF6 with hydrolysis, XCOF4. So XCF6 with once again hydrolysis, XCO2F2. XCF6 once again hydrolysis forming XCO3. Then how we have to differentiate? Remember, it is complete hydrolysis. What is this? Complete hydrolysis give rise to XCO3. How to remember complete hydrolysis? We need 3 water molecule. So 3 oxygen is there, you see? 3 oxygen is there, right? So XCO3, 3 oxygen in the compound. See, 2 oxygen is there, right? 2 oxygen, partial hydrolysis, 2 oxygen is there. 1 oxygen is there, right? So partial hydrolysis, 1 oxygen is there. That is the trick to remember this hydrolyzed product. Remember, hydrolyzed product. So another important thing is oxidation state remains same. Here also it is +6 oxidation state. Here also it is +6 oxidation state. Oxidation state will never change. Remember that point also. XCF6 undergo partial hydrolysis forming XCOF4, XCO2F2. Complete hydrolysis forming XCO3 plus HF. This is about group 18. So this is the synopsis part. So all these sheets in the snapshot, I will make a PDF file and I will send to Instagram group. So if you are not joined yet, so the link is given in the description box. So join to Instagram group, so that I am going to give very important some tips or tricks other than this. So in that case, and all these, the YouTube links will be there, and all these PDF files will be there, flowcharts will be there. Remember, all these things will be there in the Instagram group. So this is about group 18. Now it's time to discuss previous year questions. Now we'll discuss previous year questions. So one thing you remember, if you perfect with synopsis, previous year questions can be finished in 10 minutes. Remember, 2014, 2018, almost 12 to 13 questions, we can finish it in 10 minutes. Very, very important. First one. So 2018 ಆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ವೆರಿ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಬ್ಟೇನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ವೆರಿ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಅಂತ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಏನ್ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಬೇಕು ಅಸೈಡ್ ಅಸೈಡ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ವೆರಿ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಆರ್ ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಅಸೈಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಸಿಇಟಿ ನೀಟ್ ಜೆಇಇ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ವೆನ್ ಪಿಬಿಒ ಟು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಎಚ್ ಎನ್ ಓ ತ್ರೀ ದ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇವಾಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ 2018 ಆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ So when PbO2 react with concentrated HNO3, the gas evolved is. So which is the gas evolved? See, the gas evolved in this particular case. So PbO2 react with concentrated HNO3. So give rise to here PbNO3 twice plus H2O will be there plus oxygen gas will be evolved. Remember, oxygen gas will be evolved. So this is the answer. Oxygen gas is the answer in this particular case. That is answer B. Very very important. The answer is B. Remember that. Then we will see question number three. Question number three. Which of the following is correct dot structure? Electron dot structure for N2O molecule. N2O molecule. Remember. So one thing you remember, electron dot structure or Lewis structure, what we call it as Lewis structure, it should be octet arrangement. Octet arrangement. Now, don't see the option. Now you'll see the structure. N double bond O or N triple bond N single bond O. This should be the structure. Correct? So, N double bond and double bond O, you have two options, and N triple bond you have one option. This is not the option. Now you will see 8 electrons are there or not. See, in this case, one bond means 2 electron, right? Double bond is there. 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 2. 6 electron is there. Correct? So this is not the answer. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 electrons are there. Correct? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 electrons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 electrons are there. Right? But in this particular case, there is no charge. So there is no charge is mentioned. Hence, this is also wrong. So charge how to mention? So here, N double bond. N can form three bonds easily. When it form two bonds, remember, it should be of minus charge. When nitrogen forming four bonds, it should be of positive charge. Then only the statement is correct. Now, the answer for this question is this. Because you can say everything is followed. Minus charge, plus charge. Minus charge on oxygen because single bond whenever it is formed oxygen, minus charge you have to write. So nitrogen forming four bonds here, so forming positive charge. So here 8 electron system is also followed. Hence the answer for this question is B, remember B. Then this one, 2017 asked question. 3ClO minus give rise to ClO3 minus plus 2Cl minus. The reaction is oxidation, reduction, disproportionation, decomposition. See oxidation state. Plus 1. Here it is plus 3. Here it is plus 1 plus 3. Yes. Here it is, remember. So minus 1. Minus 1 already it is there. Plus 1 to minus 1 is reduction. Plus 1 to plus 3 is oxidation. Then what is the reaction? It is called as very very important disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation reaction. Remember that. Then which of the following forms P pi bond with itself? See, P pi bond with itself. See, P orbital should be there. There is no D orbital. Hence, answer should be N. Answer should be N. Very simple question which was asked in 2017. Then, which of the following noble gas has an unusual property that diffusing through materials such as rubber, glass and plastic? Rubber, glass and plastic. Very, very important, I told. Correct? So, this is all, remember, fact type question. Immediately, you have to tell the answer. You have to remember this fact. So helium is the one which can diffuse through glass, plastic and rubber. This is 2017 asked question. Then we'll move to. Then question number 7. Question number 7 you can see 2017 asked question. Which is the select wrong chemical reaction. Wrong chemical reaction. See. MnO to HCl. Give rise to Cl to MnCl to H2O. Correct? So it is a right one. It is a right one. 8NS3Cl2, NH4ClN2. Erdu nitrogen ide annale idu excess of NH3, that is the reaction is correct. CaOH twice plus Cl2 formation of bleaching powder I told, right? But this you can see 2NaOH plus Cl2. What will the product? Remember 2NaOH plus Cl2. So give rise to NaCl plus NaOCl plus H2O, NaOCl should be formed. Hence, remember, this should be the one which is wrong chemical reaction which was asked in 2017 exam. Then, 8th one, the property of fluorine which is not true is, which is not true. See, most of its reaction is exothermic. Correct. It forms only one oxo acid. No doubt, highest electronegativity, very, very important. And high bond dissociation energy. This is the exception you have to remember. I have made this point very clear. High bond dissociation energy is the one which is not true. Hence, 2016 asked question. Answer is B. 9th one. Which is true regarding nitrogen? Very simple once again. 2016 asked question. Which is true regarding nitrogen? Less electronegative? Have low ionization enthalpy? Correct? Less electronegative? Correct? No. Nitrogen is the highest electronegative in that group. So d orbitals are available, wrong. Have low ionization energy, wrong. So answer, ability to form p pi p pi bond, that is 9th question. Correct answer is D, which was asked in 2016. Then in this particular case, 10th question. Yes, 10th question, we will see. 10th question, we see shape of Xc F6 is 2016 asked question. Shape of XeF6. First, I will tell you hybridization. One thing you remember, pyramidal is possible from only sp3. Correct? Square planar is possible if it is dsp2. Or remember, sp3d2 with two lone pair. Square pyramidal is possible sp3d2 with one lone pair. Distorted octahedral is possible sp3d3 with one lone pair. Remember that sp3 with one lone pair pyramidal. Now you have to calculate hybridization. So hybridization calculate madodu hege, I have made a separate video, I told you can refer that. Otherwise I will tell you this for this XeF6, right? H is equal to half into, so valence electron plus monovalent minus cation plus anion. This is the formula you have to use. Now you can see half into valence electron of xenon is 8 plus monovalent, fluorine is monovalent, so 6, and then this is not the cation anionic charge. 14 by 2 is how much? 7. 7 means how much? sp3d3. sp3d3 means what? With one lone pair, remember. So distorted octahedral structure. So answer is B. So in this case, 11th question. So AB, it should be ABCD. Yes. When a brown compound of Mn treated with HCl, it gives a gas. Right? The gas B in excess react with NH3 to form explosive compound C. Now if you see NCl3, NH4Cl, only two options, right? Which is explosive? See, if you don't know about NCl3, also fine. But you have to be very clear about NH4Cl. Because NH4Cl, you have touched with your this fingers, because you have used this in the laboratory test. Remember NH4Cl, how the adukke NH4Cl never be the explosive compound. This should not be the answer. Now three left. Now NCl3 formed excess, which is there. Excess means what? Cl2 is correct, no doubt. Eradu kade Cl2 na ide, but out of these two, brown color compound, I told Mn1 brown color compound is there. Which one? MnO2, very, very important. MnO2 is brown color compound. So answer for this question is A. Remember that. In the last question in this, sorry, no, it's not a last question. Fine. 2015th asked question. On heating with concentrated NaOH solution in an inert atmosphere of CO2, white phosphorus gives a gas, which if the following statement is incorrect about the gas. See, highly poisonous, definitely incorrect. Concentrated NaOH react with inert atmospheres of CO2, white phosphorus. Remember, white phosphorus react with concentrated NaOH, which is a product formed PH3. Remember PH3, correct? PH3 highly poisonous, correct? Its solution water decompose, correct? More basic than NH3. Out of NH3 and PH3, which is more basic? Yes, NH3 is more basic, correct? PH3 more basic is wrong. Hence the answer for this question is 3. So this is 12th question. Then you will see 13. Aqueous solution of following salt will have lowest pH. So lowest pH they are asking. Lowest pH, remember, more acidic. Correct? So now aqueous solution, we will see. NaCl in water, what is going to form? Hydrolysis is the reaction. What is going to form? HClO. This gives rise to HClO4. This gives rise to HClO3. This gives rise to HClO2. On hydrolysis give rise to this compound. Now tell me which of the following is more stronger acid? HClO4. If pH is less means acidic nature is what? Acidic nature is more. More acidic nature, lowest pH. Hence the answer for this question is B, NaClO4. Now xenon has pyramidal geometry. See, which of the following compound of xenon has pyramidal geometry? I told pyramidal means only one possibility, sp3 hybridization with one lone pair. One lone pair, correct? Now you can see sp3 hybridization. So calculate the hybridization, use the same formula which I told. So when you calculate that, you will come to know that XCO3 should be the answer. XCO3 should be the answer, because here you will get sp3 dehybridization. So here XCOF4 will get sp3 d2 hybridization, XCF4 also will get sp3 d2 hybridization. This is the only sp3 hybridization with one lone pair. Hence the answer for this question is D. And the 15th question, see, MnO2 react with HCl forming A gas react with F2 excess forming B react with uranium to form C and D. If you don't know about this reaction, see, this reaction will never tell. Uranium jothe react aagbeku yaake bekadu namage, hoda bitbidri. But the important hint is, remember MnO2 HCl, which gas is released? O2 or Cl2? O2 or Cl2? O2 or Cl2? MnO2 HCl, definitely Cl2. Important reaction I told. Now you see, Cl2 with F2 excess, F3 no FO, F2 excess means F3 or F, definitely a small child can tell F3, F excess means F should be more. So the answer should be this one, this is 2014 asked question. Last question of this P block elements. Yes, very good. The statement that is not correct is, see, solid PCl5 exists as PCl4 plus PCl6 minus, very, very important, which can conduct electricity because of this reason I told. Definitely it is correct statement. Fine. Phosphorus acid on heating disproportionate to give, I told phosphorus acid S3PO3. Disproportionation give rise to which is the acid? S3PO4 plus PH3, right? Phosphine PH3, but S3PO4 is not metaphosphoric. Remember, it is not phosphoric. It is orthophosphoric acid. Hence, remember, incorrect should be second option. Then hypophosphorus acid reduces silver nitrate to silver. It is correct. Ekandre the hypophosphorus acid is good reducing agent. Pure phosphine is non-inflammable. Also, I have told very important one. The answer for this question is. So this is about the P block elements, the CET part, synopsis I have explained, then the questions. If you understood this part, like the video, share to your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.